Welcome to the session. This is our second session in a series, how to become a cost management accountant. And as you know, this is a free training for whoever is interested in. When this proposal was shared with Mrs. Jyotsna Rajpal, she graciously accepted this one to train the new aspirants how to become a CMA. In the last session, she had covered what are the basic requirements, eligibility requirements to become a CMA. And in this session, she has got another agenda according to the overall picture. In short, her profile, as you can see, she's a cost and management accountant. By education, she has got MCom and MPhil, and she has been in industry for more than 30 years, covering more than 20 industries. Without much of delay for you, I'll request Mrs. Rajpal to please start the second session. All over to you, madam.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Arvind. First of all, I would like to just recap what we had in the last program. Who can become the CMA? The major subjects, what is the career as CMA? And who may get into this course. And today we will see that what are the steps we need to follow to get into this particular course. So there are, if I categorize these five steps or five ways to get into this course, I can just broadly categorize into two parts. Like one is, if someone has passed 10 plus 2 and he aspires to go through foundation course of the Institute of Cost Accountants of India, so he can pass that examination and he can take admission in the main course. Or other way is that by virtue of having some degree which are specified, like he is either intermediate of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, or he has passed foundation of ICSI, that is Institute of Company Secretaries of India, or he has passed the foundation and level part two examination of CAT, that is Certificate of Accounting Technicians, or he has done graduation in any discipline other than the fine arts. So they can take direct admission in the main course. By virtue of having these certificates or degrees, they can directly enter in the main course of the CMA. So now we can go towards the next slide. First slide for today. Yeah. So in case of first condition, like when someone aspires to go through the foundation course way. So in that case, he has to apply directly online. He can apply, he or she can apply online. Then along with the application, he has to submit attested copies of the 10th certificate, matriculation certificate means the 10th pass certificate he or she has to attach. Then attested copy of the 10 plus 2 certificate or marks statement, either or these two documents one has to attach along with the application. And then one has to attach three copies of the photographs, passport size photographs. One will be pasted on the application form, another will be pasted on the identity card, which is part of the application form, and third will be just attached to the application. No pasting is required. It has to be simply attached. So these three things are required along with the online application form. Application form is available at the rate of 250 rupees. And along with the examination fee, one has to submit these documents online, as well as physical documents can also be submitted in the local chapters or in the regional councils, depending upon the location of the candidate. So one can submit those documents physically also. And everywhere we have used the term attested copy. So attested copy of all the documents have to be attested by either the Institute of member of the Institute of Cost Accountants of India, or Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, or Institute of Company Secretaries of India, or any member of Parliament, any member of State Legislative Assembly, or a gazetted officer, or a principal of a college. These people are authorized to attest the certificates to be attached with the application form. So we need to do basically two things to apply for this. Like, first, we need to have 10th and 12th certificate, which needs to be attested from either of these designated people. And we have to attach 3 passport size photographs along with the application, and we have to simply send them. We can go to the next slide. A person, we'll see a person who is not opting through a foundation course, if he wants to take admission directly by virtue of having either of those 4 qualifications, means either he is a intermediate pass out of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, or he is the foundation pass out of Institute of Company Secretaries of India, or he is level 1 or level 2 passed out of CAT, or he is graduate in any discipline except the fine arts. So in that case, the person, candidate, has to apply online. Again, he can apply online. Along with the application, one needs to put 3 documents. Like in first case, we saw we need to submit 2 documents. Here we need to submit 3 documents. Number 1 is matriculation, means 10th certificate. Then 10 plus 2 certificate or mark statement, whatever the case may be. Then degree or certificate, whatever is the base document for exemption in the foundation course, that we need to submit along with the application. And then all these 3 documents have to be duly attested by the same authorities which have been specified in the last slide, either member of the CA, CWA or CS Institute, member of Parliament, or a member of a State Legislative Assembly, or a gazetted officer, or a principal of a college. So either of these members have to attest those documents. And then along with the 3 passport size photographs, these need to be applied online, and physical documents have to be submitted in the local chapters or in the local regional offices, whatever is available nearby, depending upon the location of the candidate. Next slide we can go to. Now the question comes that when can we apply? When to apply? Like we see in most of the courses, it's all like time bound. So here also, though the admission is open throughout the year, but students desirous to appear for June term examination or December term examination, they have to specifically decide that whether they want to apply for June or they want to apply for December. Like I told you last time that we this institute conducts exams twice a year. We have a semester pattern here. So exams are conducted June and December every year. The result for June term examination is out by September, and result for December term examination is out somewhere in the mid of March. So one can apply accordingly. So whenever he or she wants to appear, or whenever someone is able to achieve the basic qualification, like if you are passing out your 12th examination in the month of June, then in that case, or in the month of say May or June, if you are passing out, then before 31st July, if you apply, you will get the December term of the examination. If your 12th result is coming out somewhere in the August or September, or any qualification which certificate of which is being issued during the month of August or September, in that case, deadline for you will be 31st of January. Like we are approaching to 31st of January. So now if you want to appear for June 2021 examination, it's the right time to apply, right time to register for foundation examination. Okay, this thing, please be very clear about it. Then comes, once you are clear with the foundation, then when to take admission in the intermediate examination. Similarly, intermediate examination also, admission is open throughout the year. Anytime you can enroll yourself. Whenever you have a desired qualification, you can go and enroll yourself. But students who have a specific target to appear for June examination or December examination, they need to apply for June examination. You need to apply before 31st of January. And for December term examination, you need to apply before 31st of July. So the deadlines for both the steps are same. The only thing is, it will depend that when you have the desired qualification to apply for a particular admission. Admission happens throughout the year. There is no particular period of taking the admission. The only thing which will decide on your date of taking the admission is that whenever you take the admission, accordingly, you will be able to appear for the examination. Like if you take admission in the February, then in that case, you can appear in the examination in the December. Like from February to 31st of July, you can take admission, you can appear in the examination in the December term examination. Or from 1st of August to 31st of January, if you are registering yourself, getting enrolled yourself, then you will get the June term examination. So this is very important as far as this course is concerned. So we can move to the next slide. Now comes the examination for the foundation course. So in foundation course, we have four papers. We have four exams. Under one set of examination, we have to appear in four papers. So first of the paper is Fundamental of Economics and Management. Here, paper one is for, part one is for the economics and part two is for the management. This complete paper is theoretical and everything related to the economics, basics of the economics, like currency and banking, then fundamentals of economics, microeconomics, macroeconomics, all these basics of the economics are being taught in this particular paper. And then basics of the management, what are the management functions, what are the normal management procedures, that all is being asked in this. The paper level, examination level, and level of understanding is very basic. You need to have a fundamentals cleared to pass in this examination, in this particular paper. Then paper two is Fundamentals of Accounting. In this paper, we have two parts. One is financial accounting and other is cost accounting. Financial accounting part is 80%, weight to the financial accounting part is 80% and weight given to the cost accounting part is 20%. Financial accounting, we have all fundamental basic concepts related to financial accounting. Then in that case, in case of fundamentals of accounting, in case of financial accounting, we have basically three portions. One is the fundamental, other one is preparation of the final accounts. So likewise, we can, this 80% marks is covered. Then comes cost accounting part. In cost accounting part, we have very basics, like what is cost, what are the basics of the cost, on what basis costs are allocated, and what is the basic format of the cost sheet. That is all about the cost accounting portion. And weight given here to the cost accounting portion is 20% only. This paper consists of numerical problems. So here you need to be, this has very less of theory and it has more of the numerical problems, so you have to be very careful about this particular paper. And level of understanding for both the points, like financial accounting as cost and cost accounting, one has to be like, one has to have the knowledge of the basic fundamentals and clarity about the fundamentals, because this is the basic, very basic paper. If you're not clear about it, you won't be able to do, or you won't be able to perform much better in the main examinations. So you need to have clarity in this particular paper. And rather you should, and this is scoring paper also, being a numerical paper, it is a scoring also. So here you can get good marks in this paper. Then comes paper three. Paper three is fundamentals of laws and ethics. In this paper, we have two parts. One is commercial law and another is the business ethics. In case of commercial law, you know, all the law, entire law is like divided into many acts. There are so many acts. We count maybe hundreds or thousands of acts in India. So in this case, we have to study three basic commercial acts. First of them is a contract act, which is the basis of the entire business. The entire business principles, entire business dispute, entire business is done on the basis of the laws of contract. So our contract act is one of the very important act as far as business is concerned. So first is contract act. Then second is negotiable instruments act, under which all the banking transactions, all the negotiable instruments like bank, demand draft, all these things are covered under that negotiable instruments act. And then we have third act, that is known as sale of goods act. So whatever sale and purchase is being done in the business, you know, business is all about making purchases and selling our goods or selling our services. So all those activities, all those transactions are covered by the sale of goods act. So these three acts together are forming 70% of the syllabus. And then comes the business ethics. Ethics are also one of the most important part of any business. To run a business, you need to have, you need to maintain some business ethics. So some theoretical part related to business ethics will also be taught here in the 30%, with the 30% weight of the marks. So this is all about paper three. Now let's go to the paper four. Paper four is fundamentals of business mathematics and statistics. Here, the weight given to business mathematics is 40% and statistics it is 60%. In case of business mathematics, we have only algebra and arithmetic. So this 40 marks is again divided into two parts, 20-20 marks of each of arithmetic, algebra, arithmetic and algebra. And that too of a very basic, like even I think 10th standard arithmetic and algebra is there in this syllabus. And then comes business statistics. Statistics has a higher value given in this. So in case of business statistics, we have a basic study of like graphical presentation of the data, then measures of the central tendency, then we have probability, then we have coefficient of variation, etc. We have to study in the course of business statistics. So this is completely a numerical paper, and in this paper we can secure very good marks. Even if you really work hard in this paper and you have good business mathematics acumen, mathematics and statistics acumen, then I'm sure you can secure 75 to 80% marks in this particular paper. So this is the most scoring paper as far as this foundation course is concerned. So I think it's clear. Like we have one theory paper, complete theory paper, that is economics and management. Then we have another theory paper, but with little bit of practical applications, that is fundamentals of laws and ethics. Then we have a combination of theory and practical, that is fundamentals of accounting, where we will study about the financial accounting and cost accounting. And then fourth paper is totally numerical, that is fundamentals of business mathematics and statistics. I think it's clear. We can go to the next slide. Next slide, please. Excuse me. Yeah. Now I will have a look at the foundation exam details. Like, as I've already told, that every year exams are held in the month of June and December. Respective results are declared in the month of September and March. The passing marks for foundation exam is 50%. We need to have minimum 40% marks in every paper, like individual papers, and aggregate should be 50%. This is a specific requirement of our institute. So even if we are securing 40% in our theory papers, but we are securing 60% marks in our numerical papers, then we can pass out with the average of the 50% marks. So aggregate is very important. Then comes exam pattern. Till December 2019, the entire exams were conducted offline, and the paper was hard question papers were there, and we used to have all detailed questions, like subjective questions, maybe numerical, maybe the theory papers. Everything used to be a subjective thing, but for 2020, because of the pandemic, the entire question paper changed to online, and all the four papers had MCQs only. So this is a drastic change due to pandemic, and we don't know that tomorrow it will be again going back to the subjective paper and offline paper, or they will continue with the MCQs. This is a little uncertainty, but syllabus is going to remain the same, and MCQs are also they are not like only yes or no type of question. They are also like you have to do in case of the numerical papers, you will be given small sums, and then you have to take the opt for the appropriate options. So in case of multiple choice questions also, you need to have you need to be very thorough with the subject. So in case of 2020 examination, where all the MCQs were there, so 50 questions for each subject were designed. And the time allotted for these 50 questions was 1 hour, 1 hour each. So this is about the exam details. If someone has any other question, I'll be happy to answer after the session. So we can move to the next slide. Yeah, now next slide. Once we are through with the foundation, or if we are not interested, or if we have some other qualification and we have exemption in the foundation course, and in that case, if we want to take direct admission in the main course, so what is the paper pattern? What are the all course contents, and what all papers we will be studying? That we can have a look. Like the whole course, the main course is divided into two parts. One is known as intermediate, and another is known as final. Both intermediate and final are again divided into two groups. Both the courses, like intermediate course and final course, are divided into two groups each. Means in all, we have four groups. And these four groups are further divided into four papers each. Means we have two steps, two stages, you can say, stage one and stage two, stage intermediate and stage final. Then two stages are divided into two groups each, means we have in all four groups, and four groups are again divided into four papers each. So in all we have 16 papers, 8 papers in the intermediate course and 8 papers in the final course. In case of intermediate course and final course, the basic contents of the papers like income tax, accounting, cost accounting, audit, law, we study all those papers, all those subjects in intermediate as well as in final. But the intensity of the, like you can say, level of understanding for intermediate and final is different. Like in case of foundation, I told you that only we have to touch the fundamental part of all the subjects like financial accounting, law, cost accounting. So only basics, basic understanding of the subject we have to have. But in case of intermediate, we have to have a little higher level of, you can say moderate level of understanding has to be there. And same papers like financial accounting, you have studied in financial accounting and cost accounting, you have studied in foundation, then you will be studying in intermediate and you will be studying in final as well. So in case of final, it has to be expert knowledge. Means if tomorrow any industry person comes to you and if you are a final student, you should be able to sort out his problems. So the basic course contents, basic papers are more or less similar for intermediate and final, that we will see in the next sessions to come, that what all we are going to study in intermediate and final. But here we have to understand one thing, that every time or in every group, we don't study the new subjects. The subjects are going to remain the more or less same as far as intermediate and final is concerned. But the intensity of the understanding will change. In case of intermediate, we may be required to have basic understanding or working efficiency. But in case of final, we need to have expert knowledge. So this is the basic difference between these two stages. We can go to the next slide. Now, in the next session, we will see that what all subjects we have seen today in the foundation examination, like we have seen four papers we are going to have. Then what are the real course contents for those four papers? We will discuss in detail in the next session. And then what are the subjects covered in intermediate and final examination? We will have a look at a glance in the next session. So this is all from my side. I think, Arvind, we can open this for the question answers.
Thank you so much.